Hello and welcome to part three of this video series, which looks at the Wuhan coronavirus outbreak. You can see down here we are in fact February 11, 2020, and the website states that at 9:10 this morning we had 43,104 cases. We are on the Worldometer website, where you will find stacks of information and statistics on the coronavirus, including the different countries and how many cases in different countries, etc. Now, where I'm getting the data from is from this link here. If you click on cases, it'll take you to another page with more information, and here you'll find a list with all the total cases since the data was collected from January 23. Now, these are all the figures that I'm using in my Excel spreadsheet to generate the forecasting models to predict how many cases we expect to have at some point in the future. Now, if we go back to my Excel spreadsheet, I will show you the brand new model which I've created from the data, and you will see that there's been a huge change to the model. It's completely changed from the previous one we saw in part one, and the reason for that is, well, you can see it in the change in total figures here. You can see that the virus was accelerating quite rapidly at the beginning here, and you can see from the percentage change in total we're having a decrease now. So it appears like the virus is no longer accelerating like it was at the beginning, and appears like, according to these figures here, that the virus could very well die off within a week, according to the model which I have based on these figures here. So anyway, let's jump into Excel now and have a look at this new model. Okay, so those viewers that have already seen part one and part two in this series would already be familiar with this spreadsheet and how it works, but I'll just quickly explain. Here we have the total real cases, which are the cases that we just saw on the website, the published cases. The ones in the red here are actually forecasts from my new model, which is this model here, and we can see it's changed dramatically from the original one. The original model that we had was along those lines. It was a polynomial of second order, you can see. The new one is a fourth order polynomial equation, which is the actual model that I'm using to predict or forecast the evolution of the virus into the future. So I guess the first thing to do is to verify that the model does actually work based on the historical data. And we can do that by simply checking, well, if the model is correct, it means that at day four, we should have about 2,800 cases. So what we do is in the day number box, text box here, we type in day four, and then we press compute, and it tells us that we should have about 3,162 cases on day four. So it's a little bit out, but it's not far off. Now let's try February 3rd, which is day 12, and we should have about 20,500 cases. So I'll put day 12 in the box, and then we'll press compute, and it's showing that we'll have 20,958 cases on day 12, which is not too bad. We're only off by 300, which is not a lot. Now, let's try day 18. We'll try day 18. Day 18, and we'll press compute, and we've got 40,668. 40,553. It's not bad. It seems to be actually getting better as we move along in time. So the model appears to actually be more accurate the further in time we're getting. Let's try day 19. Day 19. 42,900. 43,100. We're not far off. Now the values in red here, obviously, are future values estimated by the model. And we can see that as we progress into the future, the number of cases is diminishing according to this new model, which is based on this historical data here. And as we saw on the website, the trend is for the acceleration of the virus to be decreasing. So according to this new model, when can we expect the number of cases to reach zero? That's an interesting question. Let me switch over to sheet 4 so we can have a better look. So here we are in sheet 4. Here we can see the latest chart with all the latest data contained from the website, which is here. And it's represented by the blue line here, which is 19 days worth of data. The data provided by the website started on January 23, 2020, which is represented by day 1 on the horizontal axis, which shows 29 days of data there. If we go to the vertical axis, we see that we have the cases represented on the vertical axis from 0 cases to 50,000 cases. Now at the moment, the blue line has reached its peak level here, which is 43,000, as mentioned on the website. The yellow line here represents the this model here, which is the fourth order polynomial model, which has been created based on the information contained in this blue line. And we can see that the model tracks the real data quite well. It's not out by much at all in all the previous data. And we can see that by the time you reach day 21, the acceleration of the virus comes to an end, and in fact enters a period of deceleration. And by the time we get to day 28, the model predicts there'll be zero cases. If that happens, that will of course be good news, but I will continue monitoring the data as it comes out each day, and I will update this model if need be so that we are tracking the virus in the most accurate way possible to be able to forecast into the future as accurately as possible. So if we look at the model, the yellow line here, I've actually calculated all the values which the model predicts for each day, and we can see here that for each day the model calculated value is not too far off from the real data. As we progress into time, we can see that the model is actually getting more and more accurate. It's not far off the real data. And we can see that by the time we reach day 29, we're actually in the negative, which means that sometime between day 28 and day 29, we should have zero cases if the predictions of the model actually eventuate. So here we are back in animation view. Now if we have a look, there's the chart. This is the model. And if we have a look at the real data, we can see the real data finishes at day 19. It was accelerating quite fast at the beginning, and you can see here that it's flattening off and even starting a downward trajectory there. If we have a look at the model now, we can see that the model tracks the real data quite well, and we can see that it's all, by the time we get to day 21, 22, we've sort of reached the peak, and then we'll see a deceleration in the number of cases. So we'll see a reduced number of cases coming up on each subsequent day. Now I will continue looking at the data on the website, and if there are any major changes in the trajectory of the blue line here, which is the real cases, then I will adjust the model and put out a new model which will continue to track the virus in the most accurate way possible. So to finish off, I just want to say that let's not forget that this is just a model, and the model is based on the data provided by the website. If the data on the website is flawed and or contains inaccuracies, then obviously the model is not going to be as useful in its predictions. And of course, the other thing is that the virus can change in its current trajectory, the blue line here that we see. So if the virus trend changes in the next few days, then obviously this model won't be correct, and the model will need adjustment to continue to forecast into the future accurately. So keeping that in mind, thank you for watching this video, and should there be need to make a fourth video with the new model, I look forward to seeing you in that one. So goodbye for now.